Hi friends, today I'm going to teach you how to stream a live video on YouTube using a Handycam. For that, you will need 8 things. First is your YouTube account with a live streaming key. Then you will need a software called OBS. OBS is a software that helps you to stream live videos onto YouTube. But before that, you will need the hardware. First we'll start with the Handycam. You will need a Handycam with an HDMI output like this. Okay. And then you will need a laptop, probably a MacBook Pro or any laptop with a Thunderbolt input. Okay. Then you will need a mini recorder. This is a Ultra Studio mini recorder. What it does is, generally the laptops, they don't have a HDMI input. The HDMI port in these laptops is a HDMI output port. And this mini recorder, it basically is an external HDMI input device. So you'll need an HDMI cable that will go from your camera to this device. And from this device, you will use a Thunderbolt cable to plug it to your laptop. Okay, and to run all of this, you will need a software. When you buy this device, you get this software free with it. So let's go ahead and set it up, and I'll show you how to get the live streaming key from a YouTube account and use it in the software and stream yourself to the world. Okay.
Alright, first things first, let's help you with getting the live streaming key. Go to your YouTube account and go to the upload section. And on the upload sections page, on the right hand side, the live streaming button is there. Click on getting started and it'll ask you some verification questions. Just answer the prompts and we'll quickly go through that, and you'll land on the streaming page. At the bottom of the streaming page is the streaming key. The live streaming key is a very unique key. Don't reveal it to anybody else. Mine is a fake account, so I can show it, but you keep it a secret for yourself. Now, we'll talk about the software that's gonna make it all work, the OBS software. It's very easy. You just go to the OBS website, type in OBS live stream on Google, and the website will pop up on the search list. Here we go, and go to the download section. You can download Windows. Mine is OS X, and here the download begins. It'll take a little while, depends on your internet connection. Mine's a bit slow, so I'll get back to you after it's downloaded. Okay, so it's downloaded now. You simply click on the package and it's very easy. Just click on continue install. It'll ask you for your personal password of the system. Fill it up. Yeah, successful. Then we'll install the Blackmagic Media Express software that comes with your Ultra Studio mini recorder. And it's very easy. You just take the memory card that they give you and plug it onto your system, and this pop-up appears. Click on it, the same prompts appear, and you just agree and install. It'll ask you for your personal password. Fill it up and the system will ask you to go for a restart. Do the restart, and after that your system will be installed with the software. And now it's time to connect your hardware. You can see I've changed my system. My laptop is with my friend, so I'm using my editing system. You plug in the Thunderbolt to the system, then you plug it in to your mini recorder. The light glows to show you it's connected. Then you plug in your HDMI cable, and the other end of the HDMI cable goes to your camera, and mine has a mini HDMI port, so I got the cable with my camera. So you might have to buy it, or you may get it with your camera. After all the connections are made, just make sure there's some sort of a view to your camera just to test. And now we'll begin the testing. And the most important thing after this is settings on the camera. Okay, so you need to go into your camera menu and change the settings of your camera that you're going to apply to the software later. So here you can see my frame rate is 60, and then I'll go inside my HDMI resolution and set it up to 720p. You can set it up to anything higher than that, but I think 720p is quite usable, so I went ahead and selected 720p. Okay, now your camera is set. Okay, my camera is set now. Now we are going to set the softwares. So first let's open the softwares. The first software is the Blackmagic Desktop Utility, Video Utility. You go to software, check HDMI 180 FPSF, and then you open the Media Express, Blackmagic Media Express, and on the screen you can see log and capture. Click on it and your video will be there. You can check that the preview is on. This is just a test to see that all the connections are working. The main work will be done by the OBS software. So we go to OBS. You can see that there is a scene button. You click on add and you type in a name for the scene. Then on the other window we have an add button again. You select your device. We select the Blackmagic device, and this is where your camera settings will come useful. You select your device. Now you see if I select 720p 60 fps, it doesn't work. It works when I select 59.94, and here you go, your camera is directly being shown on your desktop. Now you can click on start streaming, but it won't work. Before that you need to go and paste your streaming key. So for that you can either go to the preference menu or you can click on settings. Go to stream. There's an option to paste the streaming key. You go to your YouTube account, copy the streaming key and paste it here. Okay, and then you press OK. All right, now you can see the two windows over here. One is my OBS software window and one is my account window on YouTube. The account window on YouTube is offline now, and when I press start streaming, it's collecting all the data from the camera, getting it on the computer, then uploading it onto YouTube. And after there'll be a little lag between what's happening in front of the camera and what reaches to your audience. So mine has a bit of a lag, about 300 milliseconds. So you can see, I will now play something on my laptop so that you can see there's some motion. Okay, now the video starts on my laptop. My camera is receiving it on the right hand side, and on the left hand side my YouTube channel receives it a few seconds later. So that is how the live streaming works, and I will be fiddling around with the settings to see if I can delay, if I can make the video more instantaneous without any delays. But right now it's not, I don't know how to do that. But in the bottom you saw the link. That link is required. You can use that link to share your video with your friends and everybody who wants to see the video. And your video would be saved on the YouTube channel that you own, and you can watch it later also after you have stopped the streaming. Now we'll stop the streaming. Okay. The streaming went offline and the video is saved now. So if somebody wants to watch it later, they can go ahead and watch the video. The link is at the bottom.
So I hope this video helps you a lot. And if you have any questions regarding how to stream live videos, do comment on the comment section. I'll be always there to help you out. Thank you for watching.